I gotta give you credit for being more proactive and starting to meet women. And who knows, maybe you are on a roll here or something, but don't you think it's time to raise the bar a little?
Huh?
I mean, at first I thought you were in a slump, you know? And I could, as a friend, sort of look the other way while you banged a few fatties and got it out of your system. But, you know, there's lots of good-eating fish out there. You don't have to be snacking down on carp anymore.
And I suppose the girls we partied with a couple weeks ago downtown were a couple of carp, too?
No, Laura, the one with the whiskers, she looked more like a catfish.
Oh, I see. And what about Marie?
Pop some bolts on her neck and the villagers will be chasing her.
And Vicky?
Who?
Vicky!
Who's Vicky?
Vicky, with the short brown hair.
Vicky? I thought that was a guy. I was calling her Vic.
Oh, you're out of your mind.
Look, I know I'm being a little harsh on you here because I think real friends are obligated to be honest with each other. You know, and this one that you're dating now.
Jeez.
Careful. Hey, all I'm saying is she's got cankles, for God's sake.
What?
Cankles. She's got no ankles. It's like the calf merged with the foot. Cut out the middleman. She's got, like, coffee cans.
I know
down
what
there.
Cankles are. Rosemary doesn't have them.
You know what? I know what you're doing here. You're scared.
Scared?
Yep. This is exactly what you did with the knockout with the weird, frinkly toe. You're just inventing reasons to dump girls because you're afraid.
All right, look, I admit Rosemary is kind of cool, all right? But you have to admit you wouldn't even be talking to that woolly mammoth if her father wasn't the president of your company.